What's good, YouTube? Today I'm gonna give you guys all of my settings and controller settings on Warzone 3 that will allow you to get higher kill games and become a better controller player. As always, if you enjoy this kind of content, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe as it's the best way to support my videos. And if you do want to watch gameplays live, I'm live every single day, kick.com/itsmajor or the link in the description. Let's get into it. So before we get into all the settings, I'm gonna show you my controller. So I run a Cinch PS4 controller. Basically what a Cinch controller does, it has the two back buttons on the back that allow you to slide cancel. I do have mouse click triggers on it so you can shoot without pushing down all the way, so it helps with pistols and things like that. I do use Inferno control freaks that allow you to basically, as you can see right here, it's raised up off the thumbsticks a little bit, so it allows a higher range of motion with higher sensitivities. So this is, you know, already an advantage with these two things. If you guys do want to take a look at, you know, a Cinch controller or a control freak, a pair of control freaks, you can use code ITSMAJOR on the control freaks, and that'll be a link in the description, or you could use code MAJOR on the Cinch controller. I'd highly recommend you upgrading. At least getting the control freaks will help you out a ton. I've had a lot of people in my chat say that this has helped them out. Getting that out of the way, a good controller and a good setup really goes a long way. Obviously, if you're on keyboard and mouse, that doesn't really apply to you, but these are all my controller settings right here. I play standard, so that's pretty basic right there. I have controller vibration off, and these are my dead zone inputs. You can copy these down if you'd like. I personally run these inputs and I've never really changed it. So if you want, with all these settings, you can copy it down. Now, moving on to sensitivity, I'm a big supporter of finding your own sensitivity and just getting used to it. That's usually better for a lot of people. I don't really recommend, you know, just copying everything, because I think there's a little bit of a comfortability factor into it. However, I run 1515 with a 0.7 ADS sensitivity multiplier. Now, 1515 is pretty high for Warzone, but it just helps me move around the map a little bit quicker, and I've just been used to 1515 for a long time. For vertical aim, all this is standard. All this is 1.0. Dynamic response curve is what I run. For aim assist, I run default. Let's see what else. And that's really about it. So basically pretty standard settings here. Moving on to gameplay, I do auto attack sprint. I do have slide maintain sprint on. You can copy all these settings down. However, I do have slide only on. As you see this right here, this helps with slide canceling and you don't dive in Warzone. So I've heard people accidentally diving, and it has happened to me, even though you don't have dive on. And I've heard if you turn off slide maintain sprint, then you won't dive anymore. So that's up to you if you want to turn that off or on. I feel like my sliding is a little bit more smooth with this on, even though I do dive every once in a while by accident. I do have double tap tactical sprint on, parachute redeploy off, sprinting door bash obviously on, ADS I have hold. Another big one would be prioritize interacts. You're able to tap to loot. And that's really about it. So you can just copy all of these down. And that's it for controller settings. Very basic, to be honest. Now, I will go into my graphics settings. This will be more for the PC fellas. Again, this is basically your preference for your PC. A lot of these settings, I don't know if you could even run with your PC. I don't know. I run low just to get the most frames. But I do have a 4090, so that helps with it a lot. I run full screen borderless. I do run 1440. I just have automatic aspect ratio on. I run 58 brightness. I do have on plus boost for NVIDIA Reflex low latency. This is kind of weird. This is like a new one, this eco mode preset. I just leave it on. I try to turn it on custom, and then you like turn it down like just for max performance, but it always goes back to efficiency. So I don't know. I just leave it where it's at. I don't have VSync on. I do have unlimited frame rate quality. Like I said, I have DLSS on, and I basically run low or very low settings. Again, all of these settings would basically based on what PC you have, but honestly, I recommend running low and normal just to get the most frames that you can. I run 119 FOV. Affected and no motion blur, no film grain, the least camera movement, and I don't run inverted flashbang. Now, audio settings, I run PC speaker. These are my audio settings right here. Audio in this game is atrocious, so it really doesn't matter what you put on. I would just recommend running what you feel comfortable and what's good for your system and your headset, but the audio on this game is actually trash, so it really doesn't matter what you have, to be honest. And that's really about it, man. That is all my settings. If this did help you out, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Like I said, it helps me out a ton. And go drop a follow on the kick, man. If you want to watch these gameplays live, I'd love to have you guys over there, man. And if you have any other videos you want me to do, drop it in the comments, and I'll see you guys in the next one.